Hello everyone. So this is Fugue still, and I wanted to reapproach measure 22 or maybe even 21. It's just not the way I would like it. And I was talking to somebody, or somebody had commented on these two measures, and they basically said it was awkward. The harmonic progression. Let's listen. Now, she said that it was measure 21, but I think she's talking about measure 22. And let's listen to this entire episode. So it goes smoothly up until measure 22. Let's see, this D flat, F, D flat. But I want to re-engineer measure 22. Let's break it down, starting with the bass note. All right, so we're in the key of A flat, I think. A flat. We started in A flat. We're in the key of G, but we're in A flat right now. A flat territory. Actually, C minor, sorry, read this as an, I'm a treble clef reader, so bass note is a C, G, C, E flat, then G major, then C, C7, then F, borrowed chord from the major, then 6 from the A minor, borrowed chord from C major, and then this is a D flat chord, which would be the Neapolitan 6 chord, but with the A flat. So the N6 chord sounds fine to my ears. It's not an N6 right away, but the N6 is a D flat chord. D flat would want to go to the G flat chord normally. G flat, and our objective is to get to the G. And then we got this B to work with. So in the key of C, the B would be Locrian, so we can have a half diminished here. Half diminished should sound like this. I wouldn't have a problem with a D, B be half diminished. So that's what it kind of sounds like. So let's think about this. The only problem I have that is that if you're going from a 1-3-6-2-4-5 structure, the problem is that the N6, it wants to go to the dominant. So it wants to go to a G chord. So that actually sets up pretty nicely for a 1-6-4-5-1 cadence. So let's see if we can figure this out. So we got a B here. We can even just do a B. So this F is to go to a G, but we're gonna take it down an octave. B. N6 wants to go to a 5 chord, so we'll go in the key of G, a 1-6-4-5-1. Okay? So I think that would sound really good actually. Nice Locrian sound. It's a nice escape tone. I think that's an escape tone. Got a D, a C accent and neighbor tone. So we're gonna need a B. All right, and now we're pedaling a D here, so it's gonna be a 1-6-4 temporarily. That kind of sounds pretty good. I like it. It's just that the A, you can get into a lot of trouble with the altered tones. Here's what it sounds like without the altered tones. I'm going to keep that E flat. Where's that E flat? Hold on. Flat. So we got an F sharp. That's a tough one to get away with. It definitely tugs your ear whenever you use an altered chord. Right here, I'm using a flat five. Here's what it sounds like without the altered chord. Lot easier to listen to. So I'll leave this one as an A flat just because it tugs on the ear a little bit, but I think it works. Only problem is that it clashes with this A up here. Another thing, this sounds dominant, so it's a little bit misleading. Little bit misleading. Oh, if you want to know the reasoning between the C is essentially an octavization of the C down here. I didn't want to cross voices, so I brought it up. And then it continues down. So usually whenever you leap up, you want to come down, and then if you leap down, you want to come up. So let's listen to. So this is an F sharp. Cool. F sharp. This is listen to the difference. That's a lot better because it's upper neighbor tone now. Accented upper neighbor tone. It's when you go from a G to an A back down to a G. Listen to it in context. Flat 9 makes it a little bit smoother. And a little bit of chromaticism. the sound I'm looking for. Has a lot of interest to it, chromaticism. Let's listen to the whole song now. Let's see what this sounds like with a dominant. Kind of needs that C sharp in there.
Thank you.
I think that sounds really mature. Let's see. B, F sharp, D, B, G, E. It's going to kind of like an F sharp minor. Yeah. Okay, that's already a G sharp. It's got a real mature sound to it. Sounds like before. Yeah, definitely clashes. Clashes less with the dominant. So this is like an A, 6, and then last minute it goes to a dominant. And then it goes to a B minor. Dominant A. An A dominant wants to go to a D, but instead it goes to a B minor, which is pretty cool. Not in the key of A, but in the key of D, it is awesome, which we came from. We came from the key of D. Right here, I think we did. Somewhere. Maybe not. We came from. This is a very chromatic piece. So we came from, yeah. This is the E chord. It's kind of like a play on the whole A dominant going to the B. That's why it sounds okay, even though it's going to two of A. It kind of, the ear accepts it because it's going to, it's a deceptive cadence if we are going to D. This is like a 505 in the A. Yeah. So we fixed a few things in this episode. And as usual, to go out, we'll play the whole thing, and then I'm out of here. All right. There was one thing that caught my eye. I know that it was supposed to be the last playthrough, but something caught my eye. Right here. What if this were anticipation? Like that so much better. Here's what it sounded like before. Sounds pretty cool, but if you do this. Actually, I'm going to leave it. I think the F sounds a lot better. Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. All right, thanks for listening, guys. And I hope you have a good year this year. And thank you for listening.